What is the lifespan of a GPU mining rig? Again, this is a really common question that people ask us. The presumption is, well, it's on 24 hours a day, it's just being used all the time, so it's probably going to break quite quickly. That's not the case. It's actually contrary to popular belief that one of the biggest problems with this type of electronic equipment, or any electronic equipment for that matter, the worst thing that you can do to electronic equipment, minus get it wet or break it, of course, is something called thermal degradation, which basically means getting hot, getting cold, getting hot, getting cold, plays havoc with electronic equipment. Now, under normal circumstances, what that means is turning it on, turning it off, turning it on and turning it off. So with our equipment running 24 hours a day at a constant speed, ultimately what you're left with is a device which stays at a very similar temperature, very similar operating conditions. And actually it's a little bit like driving your car on the motorway versus start stop traffic. It's much better for the vehicle, or in this case, much better for the equipment. So statistically speaking, the graphic cards have a certain percentage fail rate from the millions that get made. We've managed to take off a huge percentage of that, to the fact where the amount of cards which we replace under warranty is absolutely negligible. And ultimately we have cards running for many years now without a hiccup or a beat, and we intend that to be the way for this technology to move in the future. So technically they don't break very quickly. Another thing that people are concerned about then is the technical life cycle. So how long is it before a new, better, faster machine comes out? Again, normally this would be a fair concern, because generally technology moves on quite quickly. However, in the GPU world, the majority of the space is dominated by Nvidia, which is a company that we use to supply the cards. They're the best graphics card manufacturer in the world. And ultimately, because we use the very, very top end cards, it's not in their interest to self cannibalize their own market by bringing out a new card and a new card and a new card. So the technical generations between models of graphics card is typically every 2.5 to 3 years. And ultimately the performance difference between one generation and the next is really quite small, perhaps around 15%. So what that means is for, yes, in 3 years time, there's going to be a slightly more powerful machine. It's not like a machine's come out that's 2 or 3 times faster. So ultimately in a 5-year window, what you might be left with is a generation cycle, and your machine, your older equipment, might still be running just fine with maybe a 15% performance difference. But for the use in the crypto industry, ultimately the crypto market has historically moved much more than 15% each year. So it's not so much of a concern as people think. Ultimately, this is one of the reasons why we use very, very high-end graphics cards, because ultimately at the top, there's much more headroom. So the technology doesn't move quite as quickly as other sectors. Unlike, of course, Bitcoin mining on an ASIC specialized device, where every few months there's a new machine, a new machine, a new machine, a new machine. Again, where many of these misconceptions have come from. So one of the beauties of the equipment is that it will last a much, much longer period of time, and you've got much more flexibility about what you do with it in that technical life cycle.